Dale Steyn, A Timeless Experience. One chapter ends, many remains. South Africa pacer Dale Steyn, who has retired from Test cricket, believes it's impossible for him to sum up his career in red ball cricket. The 36-year-old, who made his Test debut against England in 2004, scalped 439 wickets in 93 matches and is South Africa's all-time highest wicket taker in the format. Steyn, on Wednesday, made a heartfelt post on social media where he expressed gratitude to all those who congratulated him after he announced his retirement from Test cricket. "What a ride. Just a quick thank you to everyone for the kind messages over the last 2 days. Simply blown away by all the people who have messaged, congratulated me. Thank you," said Steyn on Instagram. What does one say when they retire? "I don't really know how to sum up almost 15 years of red ball throwing. To be honest, it's actually impossible to even try. What I can say is that I've loved every second of it, from the best to the worst days. It's been awesome. Maybe I'll try to jot it down in a book one day, so I guess you'll have to wait till then. Here's to a few more years of white ball though. Apparently the T20 stuff is pretty fun," he added. Steyn, who announced his retirement from Test cricket on Monday, will continue to play ODI and T20 cricket. How it all began. A predator's eyes, an intimidating sprint to the crease, and a blur of a cherry, barely perceptible to the eye, getting past the bat before the mental faculties can process it, and the sight of mangled and cartwheeling stumps in the aftermath of a batsman's demise encapsulate the phenomenon of Dale Steyn. Steyn made his Test debut in 2004 along with a fellow rookie by the name of AB de Villiers after he impressed Ray Jennings with this raw pace and stamina in the home series against England after a combined experience of just 7 first-class games. A humbling loss on debut set him back as he picked up just 3 wickets in the game, although it included a ripper of an outswinger to knock over Michael Vaughan in the second innings. After a tally of just 8 wickets in the 3 Test series, Steyn failed to make a significant impact and was dropped from the side. After a slew of impressive first-class performances, Steyn continued to be in the radar and made a comeback in 2006 for the home series against New Zealand. Wary of not getting another chance, Steyn made his mark immediately with a 5-4 in his first Test and bowled with more accuracy and vigour than the rookie we saw 2 years earlier. He picked up 16 wickets in 3 Test matches and tormented the Kiwis with his wrecker-in-chief, Makhanya Nithani. Steyn continued to wreck oppositions and was named one of South Africa's 5 Cricketers of the Year. Despite the honour of this accolade due to the competition for fast bowlers in the side, Steyn found himself out of the reckoning at the beginning of 2007, citing the reason that he did not possess the intensity required of a fast bowler. Upon his second coming, Steyn was now a full-time version of the monster we had only glimpsed over the years. When another opportunity came knocking, an away tour in Pakistan, Steyn bumped up his pace and fizzled out 9 Pakistani batsmen who didn't know what had stuck them. In the subsequent home series against New Zealand, Steyn picked up 2 10-wicket hauls and nailed his spot in the side. Becoming the fearless. Cricket has always been about making memories, creating moments and letting fans rejoice for time immemorial. Steyn could only tell what triggered that smile. Maybe the appreciation of a youngster's immeasurable talent or a simple mind game, but it talked about a character that had never taken a step back when the chips were down. The great bowlers of the 90s, Alan Donald, Sean Pollock, Glenn McGrath, Waseem Akram, Waqar Yunis and Curtly Ambrose had been at their terrific best when big hitting in Test series was not a convention, but since the T20 dawn, the cricket world has seen a rise in the batting strike rate. However, Steyn still managed to soar over every best bowler of the 90s. The number speaks volumes of what Steyn brought to the table, but Steyn has been much more than that. Despite the world going gaga over Kagiso Rabada's incredible journey on the international stage, Steyn is still one such commodity that demands respect in the dressing room with the sheer power of threatening the opposition with his hostile pace and swing. More than records and numbers. Records and numbers aside, rather the way Steyn managed to stay at the pinnacle of the sport for close to a decade was his legacy. coming into the sport at a time when South African cricket lacked the public attention after Hansi Kroonje match-fixing scandal, he restored the hope of the nation and, along with A.B. de Villiers, set out a partnership that helped South Africa deal easily with the post-Carlos trauma. As Siddharth Moonga beautifully put it in his tribute on Crick Info, "If Test cricket is life, Dale Steyn lived it to the fullest. If Michael Holding was the Rolls-Royce of fast bowling, its whispering death, Steyn was a graceful gliding snake." Dale Steyn's bowling in Test cricket was brutal in its simplicity, or perhaps simple in its brutality. Kohli had understood that day, but the world was being amazed by it ever since he crashed Michael Vaughan's stumps into pieces in Port Elizabeth. Sadly, the Steyn gun wouldn't bring out that chainsaw anymore, nor do the batsmen get frightened at the prospect of facing the quickest bowler of the generation. The memories, however, will linger and for long.